Very well. Come then. Show us the strength of your will.
It's not the strength of my will that should worry you, but the weakness of yours.
Thank you.
defeated. You admitted defeat the moment you turned your back on us. When you turned your back on the truth, Barnabas. We are not as weak as your god believes.
Made a weapon of your weakness? My apologies. You are not the fool I took you for. Tell me you are tired, Mythos! Your stubborn defiance has stirred my long-becalmed heart, filling it with a joy that I have not known for generations! I had thought the tantalizing kiss of self-indulgence a dream forever out of reach! And now that its sweet ruin courses through my veins, I shall not be quick to relinquish it. Show me your work, Mythos, that I might revel in it!
Yeah. At an end.
And we both know the truth.
It is I who stand victorious. My will that prevailed.
Your will?
No. It was his.
Clive Rossfield.
There is strength in will. Would that I had not relinquished my own.
You relinquished nothing. What was it, if not will, that made you strive for a new world? Strive to win your master's approval. You were shown a fantasy, and you chose to believe it. But you were wrong. There is no world, but the one we live in. And that world is worth saving. Even if it means killing a god.
Bold words from one who has served the Lord so well.
Pointless.
But I almost forgot. I promised that I would make you presentable, did I not? Fulfill our destinies just as the Lord's Mother Crystals have fulfilled theirs. Come, Clive Rossfield, take what is rightfully yours. Become one with God.
No.
At long last, salvation. I'm coming home.
Mother.
does it feel?
Show yourself! Face me!
How does it feel to consume your rival's strength? To gorge yourself on their being? To edge step by trembling step ever closer to the divine? With or without a will, you are still but a vessel, our vessel. Behold how your body shudders in anticipation of its fate.
Oh, it's not yours yet.
No. Come then, O wayward child. We shall await you upon the back of the first worm. There, all shall end and begin again.
Central keep.
Held by a contingent of soldiers and bearers from the surrounding boroughs. They are the sole reason it still stands. And all it took was an army on their doorstep to bring them together.
The prospect of death does put things into perspective.
Perspective. Perhaps it's what we've lacked all along.
Same mind! I fight for the opposite!
He fights for a world in which he shouldn't have to live and die for nothing! And he fights today to give us all the chance of a better tomorrow!
Be that as it may, a handful of men cannot stand against the kingdom!
Then mayhap they are the wrong men.
Well, I'll be damned.
Our numbers are few, but I shall rally as many of my dragoons as I'm able. You, apprise the Lord Strategist of the state of the city's defenses.
Yes, Your Radiance.
And you would fight alongside us?
I owe the Phoenix a debt.
Does this vouch for my nephews?
Aye, but I still have my doubts about you.
Which we can discuss later.
Indeed.
You said you had men garrisoned in the keep. Captain, do you know how many yet remain?
Allow me to confirm. Commander?
Whatever their number, Randalar will be needing
them
all.
Gather the bodies and build a pyre in the courtyard. Quickly.
Terence.
My lord.
You will find a girl there.
A girl? We are in the middle of a war.
I owe her my life, and I always pay my debts. You are to see that she is provided for.
Dion, I cannot leave.
But you shall. If I am ever to be worthy of the forgiveness of our people, then I must earn it. And I must earn it by my hand, and my hand alone. Know that I do not ask this lightly.
And know that I will do it.
Farewell, Terence.
Clive, thank fuck. You all right?
I am. But I'm a damn sight better for seeing you, Joshua.
And Barnabas.
The king is dead.
They are, but so is their killer. He can't hurt anyone anymore. You're safe.
talk.
I'm sorry, Clive. You know I want nothing more than to go with you.
I do. But I'm glad you're heading back to the Enterprise nonetheless.
And not just for Edda's sake. Our people need to know what happened here.
You can count on me.
As can she, I hope.
Thank you, my lords.
Do you think that was wise?
Wiser than leaving a woman with child alone in the Deadlands. They'll be safer at the hideaway. For now, at least. This land is overrun with Akashic. The king himself was long turned, albeit by choice. All to serve Ultima, in his damnable quest to forge the perfect vessel.
The chaos Barnabas wreaked, upon nation after nation. How many were killed for this?
He didn't consider it killing. Or a mercy of sorts. A way to end their suffering. He truly wanted to save mankind, and ultimately use that.
As he uses us.
But why us? What are we?
What are we? We are dominance. That is our fate. But that doesn't mean we have to accept it, which is why we fight. For the right to deny it. Is that not so?
It is. For our sins. Barnabas said something else. That the Mother Crystals were Ultimas.
Ultimas? Are you certain?
We know that the Mother Crystals have been leading the land of Aether. And we also know that it's this which hastens the spread of the Blight. But what I cannot fathom is what Ultima stands to gain from that. What did you find at the Stronghold?
The truth about Ultima's prize. For so long, I believed it to be you, and you alone. Yet, it is not merely Ifrit that he desires, but Ifrit and Phoenix both. That which we became in the skies over Twinside. Only when the twin flames are joined, shall his vessel be complete. Quite why he needs a vessel is another question. Unless there is something he cannot achieve without one. Something his immaterial form precludes. Something requiring an unthinkable amount of ether and a body resilient enough to channel it. If I did not know better, brother, I would think that he meant to cast a spell. A spell 1,000 years in the making. A spell to end all spells.
And he cannot do it without us, nor without the Mother Crystals. But if we destroy them all, we will stop not only the Blight, but Ultima as well. We stick to the plan then, only this time
we face him together.
Well, it's a long walk to stone here. Let's not keep Ultima waiting.
When Barnabas fell. His magic died with him. The road to Stonehere is barred to us no longer.
You were right, Joshua. What is up ahead?
Is there no...
What happened here?
And us... We were...
It's a wonder they...
What become...
Fuck, what...
Will your grand...
Of course.
Beyond the castle wall, my parents...
I was to... May you find...
Ready, girl?
Faster!
Don't tell me. The only way to the capital...
is through that gate, just as you surmise.
There's an army down there, Joshua.
Yes, but I don't see any dominance.
Come on.
Come on.
this is for us. I wouldn't put it past Ultima. He's made nothing easy so far.
This one's bigger than the others.
And Nina, by the look of it.
We can rest here if you like.
Don't worry, I'll be fine. Look, Clive.
By the Founder, the place is a fortress.
Ready, go?
No villagers. No knights. Not even any bodies. One could almost believe the whole kingdom had turned to Kashyyyk. Be able to see all the way to... As fine a resting place as any man could hope for. Reunited with those he loves at last.
Fly, Ambrosia.
Does it bother you that we haven't heard a single human sound?
Everything about this place bothers me.
Calm before the storm.
There's only one way into that city. Across the bridge, through the main gate. Right into the midst of whatever is left of the late king's army. Are you ready for this?
as ready as I'll ever be.
Still alive, are you? Go on, then. It'd better all be here. Is that all? The stew's awful
for me these days. Yep. What's that for, dear? Bad, if I do say so myself. That it? Fine.
Covered in nicks and lumps, the lot of them. may I help you today, Clive? Come to claim your just desserts? You earned this. Best of luck out there, Sid.